Hello and welcome to New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I'm Dr. Wendy Vandilla, naturopathic physician and your host. In the studio today with me are some wonderful guests from the Sierra Vista Alzheimer's community here in Santa Fe, New Mexico. And the facility is off of Rodeo Road here in southern Santa Fe. So welcome Ruth, Velma, Jose, Letty, and Princessa to the set. So welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
And this is a residential home for 24 different residents, correct?
Yeah, elders.
Elders. And it's based on a unique model of having a home for people who have memory loss, right?
Yes.
Alzheimer's and other types of dementias.
We're the first Eden Alternative registered home in New Mexico.
And say that again, Eden Alternative? Eden Alternative?
It's an honor society for long-term care programs who are really focused on culture change, on changing the culture of how we look at elderhood, of how we look at aging, and turning it into a more human, more realistic, more family-oriented way of living. We're the first program in New Mexico. It's an international program. There are programs in Japan, Australia, England, the Netherlands, and we have been involved with this, working on it for about almost 6 years. And we're registered in 2010, September.
So this was a six-year project to become part of the Eden Alternative Society, right?
For us, it was. It is a very voluminous application process. The Eden Alternative is a turnkey model for improving the lives of the people who live and work there. You know, it's going away from the institutional model of care in residency for people with dementia and Alzheimer's. But 6 years, it took us that long. But again, we did involve our family members and our staff and took votes, and we had to write. It took a lot of writing. Right. It's almost like a thesis, you know. And
I think
so
it was our thesis.
Yeah, so it was very voluminous. But we actually got approved and registered in September of 2010.
And then the process goes on, because after registering, you go through 10 milestones to become teachers and trainers.
And how is this program? I mean, I think having Princessa on the set with us is part of the Eden process, isn't it? Or the model
it
of
is.
Bringing plants and animals and
children and also and working with the arts and also taking a role in the community with providing support and education and working on legislative issues and just looking at care and at dementia as a holistic process, as, you know, as being life.
Even with this memory loss condition, you can have a wonderful, playful, full life.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it focuses significantly on ongoing relationships, continuous relationships. Our volunteer programs, for example, are not those of the standard institutional way model of care. Our volunteers are continuous. They're the same ones over and over
for
again.
Years.
Instead of turning that roster over so frequently, because we need our volunteers to connect with the elders, with the people that live there, almost as much as the staff does.
So there's a big community involved with the elders that live at Sierra Vista.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you said volunteers, there's caregivers, there's staff.
There's
yourself,
caregivers, children and grandchildren, there's my brother, there's, you know.
So there's a lot of outside activity that's brought into the home.
Mm-hmm.
And there's also a lot of natural activity in the home. Not just from the animals, but from the fact that it's a real house. Mm-hmm. And there's real cooking, there's real, you know, it's a real home, you know. And one day, Jose, you just finished helping Luis paint, or supervising, I think.
Did you do that?
Well, once in a while.
Once in a while. And then, what about the shirts you're wearing? These lovely Sierra Vista Retirement Community loves Zumba.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm sure you know Zumba's such a big fad right now, and it's a healthy way to exercise. It's a happy, healthy movement. And so we have a wonderful instructor that she started with us. She's from Mueve. It's called Mueve, which is a Spanish word for move. Mm-hmm. And she is coming to Sierra Vista and doing Zumba classes for our staff and elders on Tuesdays in the afternoon. And so, and they love it, you know. And again, back to the Eden alternative kind of approach, it's not only for the elders, it's also for the staff.
The staff comes.
And we refer to them as elders because the true definition of an elder is that we can still learn from them. We can still learn all kinds of different things from the people that live and work there. It's not a top-heavy type of approach to care.
Mm-hmm.
So, but yeah, they all, they're having a really good time with Zumba, all of the, you know, the elders and the staff, and they get all excited about it, and it's different. It's a really nice approach for breaking the day even, because it can be hard work. It's very heavy work. It can be very draining sometimes, too. We get very, very attached, very close. They're family to us. We become their family. Mm-hmm. You know, we're with them several hours throughout the day. So it does break up and make it fun. We like to have fun there.
Good. And many of the elders, that is, Sierra Vista is their last home, right? And
yeah,
the hospice is involved at the end of life?
Yeah.
And we also do our own palliative care as well.
So. Yeah, because Alzheimer's disease, as I'm sure you know, it's a progressive degenerative disease. It's fatal. And we do make every effort to make life meaningful still in that process for them. And again, for our staff.
Is that the real difference between the Eden alternative and other care facilities?
I think so. I think it's so easy when you're facing and having lived through a potentially terminal illness. I can say this from personal experience, but it's so easy to, when you're facing as a family, as a person, a potentially terminal illness, or to let yourself become defined by a disease.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a way of saying, yeah, this is part of my life, but there's also all this other stuff in my life. There are the kids, there's the baby shower we have to plan, there's the, you know, there are the goats, there's the Zumba class, there's the, you know, and I think there's this other life, and this other life is more important than this disease. And I think it's always a balancing act, but I think it helps make the balance better. You know, to not just be a diagnosis, to get beyond that. And you're a naturopathic physician, so some mm-hmm. of this probably sounds real familiar.
Oh yeah, I mean, you said that the facility is a holistic approach to living
yeah.
in the moment. And I know when I toured the facility, it's very colorful, it's very homey. There was a lot of joy yeah. and safety.
Yeah.
I mean, the area into the kitchen, you can see, you can be part of the process, but there's some low walls
or some structure,
some low gates that prevent you from wandering in and hurting yourself. Or,
right.
or there was in the plant area in the greenhouse, there was also a gate
that
so you could look in. And I love the fact that the facility is built around an open space.
Yeah, a green space.
A green space. So you can be outside in safety.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, and when the kids come to visit, you know, we have a lot of our, we're in a kind of a crossroads where a lot of our elders aren't in their 80s, 90s anymore. They're getting younger. Our youngest is 56. So she has newborn grandbabies, and then she also has her parents who come and visit. So
wow.
it's right in the middle now. You know,
wow.
for all these years, again, and I've been doing this for 18 years, I always cared for, you know, the 80 and 90 and 100-year-olds, few of them. But they are getting younger. But so anyway, the whole approach and the courtyard that you're talking about, you know, it's real beautiful to see the grandkids come in or come and play outside with Princesa or chase the chickens and climb the trees out there. And so it makes life worth living still for them. They're not just doomed, you know, there for... and one of the differences too with, because, you know, the industry does have visiting therapy dogs, but they visit the elders. They don't live there.
And Princesa is yours, right?
Yeah.
Is your wonderful little dog.
How long have you had her? How long have you had Princess?
Tell her.
Well, my niece gave it to my old lady, and then my old lady passed away, so I can keep it.
She's 14.
Yeah, I don't know, he's already about 14, 15 years old.
And I think she's looking at the turtle down there.
Yeah, they're crazy for the animal.
And having animals and plants and dance and cooking is part of the Eden alternative and making a home.
Uh-oh, I smell much.
Yeah, again, it makes it a continuity of home. You know, the laughter, the dance, the, you know, and Jose tells stories. He's from northern New Mexico like I am, but he tells stories about when he used to go to the dances up north. And
I used to go to the dances of the Finlanders.
You're a good dancer, too.
And he's a very good dancer.
Yes.
Yeah,
I worked there a long time over in Butte, Montana. And there's a whole bunch of Finlanders from over working over there.
Finlanders. Okay.
And then there was a whole bunch of Finlanders who were working over, and I used to work with an old man. And he told me, hey, Jose, you are going to be living for a long, long time. So I'm still kicking.
This dog is very interested in this little pet here, this little turtle.
Yeah.
And Letty, how long have you worked at Sierra Vista?
I work for 12 years.
For 12 years?
Yeah, I'm caregiver. I like it, my work.
So the three of you have worked together for a long time.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Through a lot.
Yeah, it's my second house.
It's your second house?
Yes.
Wonderful. Well, I know you brought some slides that that explain a little bit more about Sierra Vista.
About Sierra Vista.
Let's look at those.
Okay, we have the one where, this kind of is just where we bring our diverse strengths to our elders. You know, Santa Fe has so much to offer in different ways. And so, you know, whether it's a rabbi, you know, that we try to bring in for some of our Jewish elders to celebrate some of their special days and rituals and that type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have another one of, and I believe it's our logo for being a registered home on the Eden Alternative. And again, it's a commitment. We are fully committed to changing the culture in long-term care. And what this is basically the logo as a registered home.
And let's have that again, because underneath it, that our goal is to transform institutional approaches to care into the creation of community where life is worth living.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the Eden approach.
And then the next slide is Sierra Vista's logo. We laugh, we cook, we dance. And I've experienced all of those when I've been to Sierra Vista. And the Zumba class that was going on yesterday when I came to visit.
Well, and part of that is we have three staff who are addicted to it. I'm not one of them, but we have three staff who are really addicted to it. So,
well, it's like you said, it's good for the elders that live there, and it's also good for the people that work there.
And it isn't
to
only
get movement.
Right. Yeah, yeah. And it isn't and only fun. Zumba. We do a lot of different exercises, and again, we try to focus on music that they like. You know, our Irish elder, we have Irish CDs and that type of thing for her, Spanish for him. It just depends on we're very focused on their individuality, their autonomy. We don't, it's not just all general all the time. And so they learn from each other too, and they enjoy the different types of music for the dancing part of it, the cooking. If they can and are able to be safe, they help with the cooking. But it's homemade soups and fresh salads, and it's very home in comparison, and not restaurant style dining all the time. It's home, and it's comfort food, and it's baked from scratch, and those types
chicken
of things.
Chicken soup and mac and cheese.
Well, as a naturopathic physician, thumbs up for home cooking.
Yeah.
And the fact that you bring different parts of society in, like children and family members and volunteers and,
we
and
had
honoring different religions. And that's a very holistic approach to caregiving.
Yeah,
and it reflects the staff that works there. Like Letty makes the bizcochitos for the holidays. My background is in the arts, so we have a lot of painting and color and murals and Northern New Mexico is such a huge part of the place too. And Velma was talking about the age, and we do. We have like 56 to 90, almost 98 right now.
That's and a big spread.
Yeah.
We had a Saturday morning where one of the staff had brought in a video of Woodstock for one of the elders who was in his early 60s. And he sat there with a 97-year-old.
And watch
Jimi Hendrix at Woodstock on video.
Wow.
And it was wonderful. And her son came to visit at the time they were watching it, and he was laughing because he said, she used to make me turn it down. Or so, turn it off.
So you have quite a spread of generation and
we
cultural
do
background.
Now. Yeah, and over the 18 years that I've been doing this, as I said previously, it's new right now for me. It's just a very clear indication about how this disease, Alzheimer's, is affecting people that are not elderly necessarily. They're younger. There are people in their 40s and 50s that have this disease now.
38,000 New Mexicans.
And is it more prevalent in any part of our population?
It actually, statistically, right now, they are saying there is a higher risk for Hispanics.
That's
right
curious.
Now, at least in this area, which they are also statistically finding more younger people.
Because you said that in your facility, you've seen younger people
that's been a change. Actually, on January 4th of 2011, President Obama signed an Alzheimer's bill. It's called the NAPA bill. And it's to actually sign into law a commitment for this country to start doing more active, having a more active role in research and funding.
Wow.
And that's been a break that they've been working, that the Alzheimer's Association and a lot of people have been working on for as long as I've been doing this, which is 13 years or longer. You know, it's probably a 20-year process. And it shows how big an impact it has in this country.
Yeah.
And it's a family disease. You know, so many families miss work. I don't know what the number is, but there's, you know, millions of dollars in work hours lost by caregivers, family caregivers who are having to miss work to take care of mm-hmm. their loved one at home. Mm-hmm. Because it is such an in-the-moment disease that you can't plan for it necessarily. If someone's having a crisis or a catastrophic reaction, what we call them, in the morning, you know, you didn't plan for that yesterday because they were fine yesterday. Mm-hmm. But in the morning when you're getting ready for work and maybe taking, you know, packing their lunch, or it can be very, very traumatizing to the family, especially when they don't remember their adult children. They don't remember significant life experiences. And part of how Alzheimer's disease works is that their short-term memory is impaired first. The long-term memory is active. They can, like Jose was telling us about his mining, mm-hmm. you know, when he worked at the mines and all that, that's very active in his memory, but can't always remember what you had for breakfast.
And it's also, I think, for families, the level of concentration and the fact that you have to pay constant attention is, imagine being and this is actually a true life example, is a single mom with a baby on her hip trying to help dad change his Depends and trying to keep dad from wandering away while she was earning a living and taking care of a baby.
That sounds impossible
and
to do all
and
that.
Two high school kids.
Wow.
You know, and that's not an uncommon situation for families. It's also not an uncommon situation for a family where children have lived 2,000 miles away from their parents for years and years and years to suddenly mom or dad or mom and dad, you know, get a call from the police department and say, look, you've got to come pick your parents up. This is a real problem. They're, you know, and walk into a house that they haven't been into in 10 years. And it's, nobody's taken out the trash for 6 months. Nobody's, you know, paid the phone bill for 3 months. The, you know, utilities are being shut off. It's, is a family disease in a whole lot of very intense ways. There's a phenomenon called shadowing where the caregiver becomes the security blanket for whoever they're caring for. I had a wife in support group and her line was, and I'll never forget this, she said he would climb inside me if he could. And imagine living with that 24 hours a day, 7 days a week when you're in your 80s or 90s, or even your 50s or 60s or mm-hmm. 20s or 30s. You know, it's something we have to take seriously, but seriously in a loving, humane, laughing, joking way, too. I mean, there's both sides. And I think it's a calling. I think it's a blessing. And I think we're blessed to do this in Santa Fe.
Yeah, and we don't, when we talk about laughter and enjoying ourselves and having a good time, you know, we're not laughing at the person. We laugh at the disease, right. You know, or the disease. And it just makes for a better moment, really, because we do live in the moment with this disease, and you can't, worry about what something may or may not be this afternoon. You know, what worked this morning
Works this morning.
Work this morning. You know, mm-hmm. doesn't, and that's, that moment is gone. We have to only approach what we have at hand, whether it's, you know, something silly that we did or danced our way down, you know, up to the kitchen or, you know, those types of things. It has to be a different approach other than just sterile and institutionalized.
Let's run through the pictures of your facility because I think those are beautiful illustrations of where you all work and live and how different it is from an institution, a nursing home type. The setting.
We have one of Lupito and yes. Ricky. This is in our house. The wall to the back is where their greenhouse is. They have a solarium, and mostly the ladies take care of the women take care of the greenhouse, the elders. They've all been gardeners, most of them. The music therapy, of course, is very important. And we also have the one of,
and there's
this is
Jose.
You.
Yay.
And he helped Luis build the chicken coop, because we got the chickens when they were baby chicks. And they're building that for the peacocks and the rabbits and whatnot, and that's the front of the building. And then we also have, this is our courtyard, and this is the part where the hacienda goes around this outdoor green space, and we keep it very bright and colorful and homey, and it's safe. It is enclosed, and that's Prince William, the peacock, and the Catherine is there somewhere. She's, of course, the peahen. So, but yeah,
the royal wedding was an obsession.
And there's the kitty cats.
Yeah, you like them. That the black one is Shadow, and Siam is the Siamese cat, and. They are brothers, and then you can see the courtyard there in the back too.
Excellent.
And then the bonfires, that's what we do at holidays, bonfires around Christmas time, but we also celebrate Hanukkah,
the Sadas, and Kwanzaa, right?
All of that, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's a beautiful illustration of Sierra Vista Alzheimer's community and where you all live and work. We've come to the end of the show. Thank you so much for coming on as guests. Letty is one of the caregivers, and Jose is one of the elders, and Princesa, your companion. Mm-hmm. And thank you, Velma Ariano, the executive director, and Ruth Dennis, for social services director. This has been another show of New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I'm Dr. Wendy Vandilla, naturopathic physician. And please view the end of the show for contact information for Sierra Vista and more information about the Eden Alternative. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you, Harvey and Dottie, for operating cameras. Thank you, Marshall, for directing.